We're now ready to polish our painted surfaces. Sometimes wax isn't enough to restore the shine or luster back to the paint, and that's due to oxidation. Oxidation occurs when the top layer of paint dries out and becomes chalky. At that point, we have to remove that top layer, and we'll be using various compounds to do that. Then we'll follow up with several polishing compounds to bring the shine back to the paint, and then the final step will be to put some wax on that to protect it. When setting your car up for polishing, make sure you're not in direct sunlight. We're outside today, but we've found some shade, so we're in good condition. When polishing the car, you want to use the mildest method first. The reason being, we want to remove the least amount of paint. Now, our Mustang is in pretty good condition. A little bit later in the tape, we're going to address some cars where the paint needs special attention. Now, since our Mustang is in good condition, we're going to be using first a cleaner wax. This particular product will clean the painted surface, removing slight oxidation, very slight swirls, and scratch marks, as well as apply a wax coat. Now, first we just apply a little to the surface, take a sponge, and we're just going to rub it into place. Now, when applying this product, I recommend that you avoid the joints where the body panels come together. If you get a lot of wax cleaner down in there, it's going to just lead to a harder cleanup. Now, we let this product dry. Once it's dried, then we're going to take a clean cotton cloth and we're going to buff it out. Remember, when buffing, to turn your cotton cloth frequently. Now, if that hasn't restored the shine and luster to our paint, we have to get more aggressive. And in that, we'd use something like a polishing compound. Now, this has a lot of grit in it, and it's designed to remove heavy oxidation, heavier swirl marks, and heavier scratches. To use this particular product, we're going to take a sponge, put a little bit of the product on the sponge, again with a back and forth motion, we're going to apply it to the surface, again avoiding our seams, and just rub it in. Now, with this particular product, we're going to remove it before it dries, again with a clean cotton cloth, turning it frequently, and we buff that off. But now that we've removed that oxidation and the scratches and the swirl marks, we have to follow it up with a wax. For that, we're going to be using a Carnauba wax. Again, a sponge. Apply some wax to the sponge. And we apply it right to the surface. Again, avoiding our seams and the back and forth motion. Now, with the wax, you want to let that dry to a light haze before we buff it off. But again, we'd be buffing it off with a clean cotton cloth and turning frequently. As you can imagine, to do the entire car this way would really take a long time. If you're fortunate enough to have a buffer at home, you can do it much faster. If you have heavy oxidation, scratches, or swirl marks, you want to use a cleaner like this number 2. Now, this comes in various grades. You'll use whatever grade you need for your application. If you have moderate scratches or oxidation, you want to use something such as this number 7. This will help bring up the luster and take away the moderate scratches and oxidation. Now, if you have very light swirls or oxidation, you'd use a number 9. Then you would follow up all these products with a good liquid wax, such as this number 26 high-tech yellow wax. Ideally, you would use a separate pad for each application. Now, we've numbered our pads so that in the future we don't mix them up. Machine polishing creates quite a bit of overspray, so there are a few areas on the car that we'll want to protect from that overspray as well as ourselves. So we're going to lay some towels over the grill, the wiper blades, and that's also why I'm wearing this, to protect my clothing from the overspray. When using the buffer, I like to put the cord over my back, and that'll prevent it from dragging across the surface of the car, possibly causing a scratch. When you are using the buffer, it's very important that you keep the buffer moving at all times. If you stop and let it sit in one spot for any longer than a few seconds, you can actually burn through the paint. Also, areas that you have to keep an eye on are raised areas. If you're at a wrong angle, you can actually wear the paint out. You have to be careful when you come up near the joints of the body panels. If there's any height discrepancy, you can also wear through the paint. Plus, again, the cleanup is a real disaster when you get a lot of material down there. Other areas you have to be careful of are objects such as the antenna, the wiper blades, any body panel part where the spinning pad could get caught in there and do damage. When using the polisher, you want to make sure you use the steady, slow motion and tilt the front of the polisher slightly up in the direction you're moving. Again, remember, don't let it stop, because that's when you can burn through the paint. We're going to be starting from the top and working our way down. Since our Mustang was in good condition, we're going to be starting with our number 7 Meguiar's. When I apply it, I'm going to put in about 3 lines for a 2x4 section. I'm working one section at a time. Here I'm cleaning off the residue with a clean cotton cloth. Just remember to follow the directions with the products you're using. On the hood, I'm jumping between the raised and the flat section. You don't want to ride up and down between these two areas, because you can wear through the paint. Our overcast day turned sunny, so we've moved the car inside to apply our wax. I've always felt that several light coats of wax are much better than one heavy application. So in that light, our first coat of wax is going to be our number 26 liquid wax, and then we're going to follow that up with a coat of our pure carnauba wax. When putting the wax on the car, I like to use a small square sponge. The reason being, the edge of the sponge gives you a lot of control in applying the wax. When you're putting it on, you want to avoid things like the body panel joints, the grill, or the antenna. Getting wax on those parts will just make cleanup a lot harder. Now, when you do the car, it's best to do a section at a time, so we'll be doing the hood first. Our wax is dried to a light haze, so we're ready to buff it off. When taking it off, I like to use a clean cotton cloth. And remember, when buffing it off, turn the cloth frequently. Now, once I get all the wax off, I'm going to take my polisher with a dry pad on it and go over the whole car. I'll do that after this coat, and then once we put the carnauba on, I'll do it after that coat as well. I'm now applying my light coat of carnauba wax. We're going to put this on, let it dry to a haze. I'll buff it off again with our clean cotton towel. Once we get done with that, then I'm going to follow up again with our dry pad on our polisher and just give the car a final buffing. The paint on our Mustang was in pretty good condition, but now let's take a look at some paint problems where polishing can really help out. One of the most common problems, deep scratches. The This is an example of rock art. That's when a two-year-old picks up a rock and creates art on the side of Grandpa's Chrysler minivan. Hopefully the scratches in the paint aren't too deep, but we are going to polish them out.
We're using Meguiar's number 2 fine cut cleaner. If the scratches are deep, you can try a medium or even a heavy cut cleaner. Again, we want you to use the mildest method first whenever we're cleaning and polishing our cars. These scratches weren't too bad. One application of number 2 removed most of them. This mark is a paint chip. Later in this video, we will address chips. Now we'll follow up with a glaze such as Meguiar's number 7 and several coats of number 26, high-tech yellow wax. Here's the trunk of our BMW 2002. Even though we've just washed it, the paint is quite dull. This is an example of mild oxidation with some grime embedded in the paint too. We're going to start the cleanup with our fine cut cleaner number 2. To help illustrate the benefits of polishing the paint on your car, we're only going to do half of the trunk. After an application of number 2, the paint is looking brighter already. Now we'll follow up with number 7. This should really bring up the shine. Now we'll apply our yellow wax, let it haze over, and wipe off. As with the Mustang, I'll follow up with the buffer and a dry pad. Here we are. If you desire, you can apply several more coats of wax to get a really deep shine. This is an example of a severely oxidized paint. The deep burgundy paint has actually turned white in some spots. To make matters worse, the owner of this vehicle wet sanded the hood in an attempt to bring back the color. This will take several applications of a heavy cut cleaner, followed with a fine cut cleaner, then a sealer like Meguiar's number 7, and some wax. This is a last ditch effort to restore the paint on this vehicle. But as you can see here, we got a little lucky. In truth, the video makes the car look really good. Up close, there were a few spots where we actually started to rub through the paint.
Unfortunately, paint chips are an inevitable fact of owning a car. There are several ways to repair paint chips. One way is to go down to your auto supply store and to buy a small touch-up stick or a small aerosol can. Unfortunately, the results of that are unsatisfactory, so I don't like using those. Another way is to bring the car to an auto body dealer and have him sand the paint chips and then spray the body panel. As you can imagine, though, that's quite expensive. Fortunately for us, though, the Eastwood Company has packaged several kits which will aid us in the repair of our paint chip. To begin the repair on our paint chip, we're going to use our Eastwood Rust Brush, which is a fiberglass bristled brush, and then we'll clean the paint chip, and then we'll clean the area with our Eastwood pre-painting prep.
The fiberglass bristles do an excellent job getting into the chip and cleaning the area.
We're going to be using our Eastwood paint pen to apply our paint to our paint chip. Now we've gone and retrieved our manufacturer's paint code. We've had an auto paint supply house mix up a quart of quality enamel paint. Now, before we put it into the pen, we will cut the paint, and you're going to need to follow your manufacturer's directions before you do that. Now, when you're going to use the paint pen, first you put in the steel mixing ball. We're going to add a small amount of paint, and then we'll put on an applicator tip. Now, the great thing about the paint pen is that the applicator tip as well as the cap are airtight, so it'll keep the paint from drying, and we don't have to clean the applicator tip after every use. One good feature about the paint pen is it puts a small controlled amount of paint onto the chip, so they're real easy to use. Now I've mixed one up with our paint for our Mustang, and we're ready to apply some paint to our chip. Now, we're going to make sure that we apply several coats, and we're going to let the paint dry in between each coat. Once the paint has thoroughly dried, we're now ready to level it to the surrounding area. First, we'll wet the area, and then onto the sanding pad, I've applied a drop of paint polish. Now, with this particular pad, all we do is put it right over the area we want to sand, and then twist it back and forth. Now that we've leveled the area, we're ready to polish. We'll put a little polish onto the pad which came with the kit, and we're going to put some polish on the area on the car. Now we'll put the two together, blend the polish in, and then just run the drill. And just wipe it off. Remember when using an auto paint to let it cure thoroughly before waxing. The hood of our 2002 has been repainted at one point, and probably in somebody's garage because there's quite a lot of dirt and dust that's trapped in the paint. This hood is a good candidate for being stripped and repainted, but we're going to try to salvage this paint. We're going to be doing something called wet sanding. When you're wet sanding, you want to make sure that you use plenty of water. The water does two things. One, it keeps the paper from getting clogged up. And the second thing is that it actually creates a slurry underneath the paper to help smooth out the paint. Now, we like to use a piece of paper wrapped around this sponge for the contoured sections of the car. When you run into the flat surfaces of the car, you can use a sanding block. You just want to be careful that you don't ride up over a raised edge because you can just sand the paint right off. Now, the paint on our 2002 has several runs in it, so we feel confident and safe that there's enough paint on the hood that we can sand it. But I just want to remind you that this is an extreme method of smoothing out paint. So if you have any doubts or any questions, I suggest that you talk to an auto body professional to make sure that you're not going to do more harm than good.
Here's an example of dirt and dust embedded in the paint. It's a little hard to see it in the video, but if you were to run your hand over the hood, these imperfections would call out to you. Again, using lots of water, we're going to first sand with 600 grit paper until the imperfections are removed. Then we'll follow up with a fine cut cleaner. If that doesn't remove the sanding marks, we'll go to a medium or even a heavy cut cleaner. Then work with progressively finer polishes until we finish with a number 7 and several coats of wax.